Honeycomb, the game that my mom bought me because she thought Modern Warfare was too violent. Yeah, I remember her asking me.
Spencer, what is this game about?
Oh, you know, Mom. Blowing things up, shooting people in the face, and gratuitous violence.
Okay, but what about this one?
Oh, you know. Blowing things up, shooting people in the face, and gratuitous violence.
But it's rated teen, so there's less blood?
Yes, there is less blood. I can still remember the sound effect. Don't you guys remember those commercials? Rated M for mature. Which is definitely not accurate, because for me it was basically rated M for... make your parents buy it for you. And at that age, playing a T-rated military shooter versus an M-rated military shooter really made no difference. It's like when a rap song is just filled with profanity, but your parents think it's totally fine because you're listening to the censored version. You're really just lying to yourself about sheltering me from the adult content, but if it makes you feel better, that's fine by me. I'm 100% I must admit, it was a little odd though, because the one time that she came down to watch me play was during an intense sequence where I was getting blasted by the hardest difficulty and all that I was doing was stabbing myself with a syringe. I know that seems odd to those of you that are new to Bad Company, but that's essentially the primary weapon of the game. Like, you whip this thing out, you stab yourself in the chest, and you're immediately back to full health. It's magical.
That's what I'm talking about. Good as new.
I happen to have been through some military training myself, and having one of these things in Quantico, Virginia would have been pretty damn convenient.
I can't make it, man. I just go on with it. I can't.
Hey, hold still for a second.
Oh, what the? Oh my god, that's amazing. What did you stick in this thing, man?
My favorite part about it is that the official name for it is the Life 2. So when someone asks you why you have a smug, shit-eating grin on your face all the time, like, are you high or something? You can look them straight in the eyes and just go, on life, man. On life. Attitude is what I love about this game, versus the rest of the Battlefield series. Like, obviously with the release of Battlefield 4, the expectation is kinda just... But when you boot up Bad Company, you're welcomed with this. I don't know about you, but I think I prefer door number 2. And before we can even meet the crew, we've gotta get you set up with a difficulty, and here are your options. Easy. Not complaining or anything, but are these bad guys actually trying to kill us? Dominate your pitiful enemy and hear the lamentations of, people they know. Easy as pie. The game essentially plays itself. Normal. AKA normie mode. They're gonna fight us, and we're gonna fight them, and we're gonna win. Long as you fools shut the hell up, that is. Fight resourceful, tough, and well-trained opponents. How Bad Company is meant to be played. Hard. Ah, deadliest army, smedliest army. Let's just get up there and kill them to teeny tiny pieces. Struggle against a seemingly infinite supply of elite killing machines. Consider buying a crying towel. Maybe two. For veteran players or masochists. And you know what, if you play this game on anything but hard, you're missing out on the pain train, which in Bad Company terms is a synonym for fun. Squad! Just to introduce you to the squad, you've got Sarge, Sweetwater, Haggard, and of course you, Preston. Sarge is the no-nonsense leader of your crew that happens to always be one day away from a retirement filled with fishing and blue marlins, but he always seems to stick around purely so he can tell Sweetwater to shut up.
Eyes open, okay? And Sweetwater. Just shut up.
What? I didn't say anything.
But you just did.
That's not fair.
We are, but what am I?
Shut up!
Sweetwater is the intelligent one, and although he unsurprisingly never does shut up, I love hearing him blab on about virtually anything at all.
You know that greed's one of the 7 deadly sins, right?
So is killing people.
No, actually, you're thinking about the 10 commandments. Now, the 7 deadly sins are greed, avarice, lust...
Sweetwater, just shut up.
Absolutely, Sarge.
Haggard is a hillbilly that can be described with one word and one word only. Truckosaurus Rex.
Truckosaurus Rex. Truckosaurus Rex. On the Truckosaurus Rex.
Hey, I think that's 2 words, idiot.
Oh yeah, thanks, man. What are you, like a librarian or something? And of course, you, Preston Marlowe, who I can only describe as a regular dude that did something wrong in a real unit, so he got reassigned to Bad Company. And he's one of my favorite characters of all time, despite the fact that he has no real distinguishing characteristics or remarkable features. He's just the new guy.
It's been great to finally become a part of
You've also got Miss July, the sensual radio operator, but just to warn you, sometimes you lose your radio signal and accidentally start receiving Xbox Live traffic, so stay on the right frequency.
Hey, you're just mad because I'll be able to do something with my fucking guitar in hands that you'll never be able to achieve in your entire life, kid. So yeah, you're gay.
I'm glad the game makes it easy on me in terms of illustrating a storyline for you, because the plot is literally killing Russians, getting gold, and then buying a Truckosaurus Rex. The end.
Wow, that's deep, man. That's like some Plato Dostoevsky type shit.
You've got a variety of different weapons to murder people with, but for me there was always like this unspoken flowchart among Bad Company players, and it never involved bullets. Like, for some reason, shooting someone in Bad Company was always frowned upon. Like, if you ever heard someone back at base saying that they shot someone, you'd be like, you shot someone? Like, why though? Now, hold on. So you mean to tell me that you were out of grenades, and RPGs, and 203s, and your knife was dull, and you didn't feel like punching him in the face, so you actually, like, shot him? Like, with bullets? Why would you do that?
Whoa, that's like fucking mean.
The XM8 is the greatest gun of all time, by the way. Not even up for debate. Like, if I could somehow copulate with this thing, I totally would. And I'm not even kidding at all. Now, you do have other options, like the LMGs that have enough muzzle flash to make Ray Charles squint, and the Hardy shotguns that I never get to use, and the suppressed submachine guns that happen to be great sniper rifles, and actual sniper rifles that hit harder than Ray Rice stepping out of an elevator. But this game isn't about the bullets, it's about the explosives. And you've got everything from grenade launchers, to hand grenades, to RPGs, to C4, to JDAMs, and even Russian airstrikes, because believe it or not, in 2008, that kind of destruction was the neatest thing ever. It was like tasting Cinnamon Toast Crunch for the first time. You just have to stand there for a second like, this is pretty freaking neato. You can carry these items while you're ghost riding the whip in a variety of different vehicles, including Russian Vodniks and T-90 tanks and buggies where Haggard has to hold onto the back because it's only a 3-seater, golden helicopters that look like something straight out of Pimp My Hind, and last but not least, a golf cart. I know I probably should have started the list with golf cart because the rest of the list doesn't even matter after I mention the words golf cart, but it's the honest truth. Like, why would you ever fool around with modern 21st century bleeding edge technology when I can just cruise around in a golf cart? It makes everything better. Just make sure that you pick the right radio station, because you got three choices. Radio Blue Steel, Radio Surf, and last but not least, Radio Spirit. I kind of feel like they missed a massive opportunity here. Like, it is Bad Company, right? So you would think that there may or may not be one radio station they could have played on loop that would have just played this song over and over and over again. But I guess not, Dice. I guess not. But I will say that the bush monsters are significantly less bushy in Bad Company 1 than they are in Bad Company 2. I don't know, man. I just miss you, Bush Monster. I don't even know what your name is, but I miss you. Like, please come back to me. I just need you in my life, man. I don't know what you're about, but you need to come back. You need to come back. And that's all that I have to say about the greatest game ever. I think I'll always love the goofiness of Bad Company, where the main characters play rock, paper, scissors, or mimic golf swings during cutscenes instead of some kind of like serious planning sequences with maps and Also, I secretly feel as if every other video game could use more Truckosaurus Rex and more Haggard in them. Especially when he talks about Democrats.
That's a neutral zone. Haggard!